Hey, if you ever ask yourself what the deal is with divorce and short sales, and you have questions about it, you come to the right place. Although the answers may not be what you expect. Hi, I'm Don Thornton. I'm known as Don, the short sale guy. And I've been doing short sale investing for 20 years. And there's not many questions in this business that I don't know. And I like to share what I know. So thank you for coming to my video. In this video, I'm going to talk to you about why divorce often leads to foreclosure and short sales, because obviously two incomes is better than one. Who gets the house in the divorce and how that works? And then finally, how do you get rid of one spouse to be able to do a short sale, because it's really hard to do it with both. So in divorce, as I said, often leads to foreclosure because when people buy a property, generally speaking, nowadays in today's society, you need both breadwinners to be able to make the mortgage payment and everything else. And so when the marriage falls apart, that means that your financial support system falls apart. And it doesn't really matter in this situation which spouse gets the house in the divorce if the property is upside down. Because one single person cannot make all the payments, which leads to a big problem, obviously. So I would say, anecdotally speaking, most of the property, most of the our foreclosure clients we've had in the last 20 years, and that's well over 1,500 of them, conservatively speaking, maybe 70% have to do with divorce. And that's why, as a real estate trainer, investing trainer, I tell my students that they should focus on divorce, because divorce by far is the biggest reason for homeowners getting into problems with their property. And I just explained to you why that is, because when you need two incomes to support everything, and those incomes fall apart, and now it's just one person, then it's untenable and it doesn't work. Okay. So what I would like for you to do is go down to the corner here and click on the subscribe button. I'd love to have you get access to all my videos and get notified when I upload a new one, because I'm sharing lots of valuable information. I'd love to be able to have you get access to that and be notified immediately. The second point in my video here is about, who gets the house in divorce. And it's funny because I've seen so many clients, they fight cats and dogs, tooth and nail. They want, one wants the property so bad, or the other one wants the property so bad. And in reality, it's moot because they can't afford it. The one spouse that I just talked about doesn't, can't support the house, the mortgage payment, without the other person's income. So it doesn't really matter. But they do, and it happens. And so, in a divorce situation, it is important that whoever gets the house is in the divorce decree and in the divorce conditions, because we need that if we're doing a short sale. And again, this is all if the property is upside down on the mortgage. Obviously, if it's free and not free and clear, but if you have equity on it, you just put the property up for sale and that's it. But a short sale is when you own more than what the property's worth. So just as a caveat there, we're talking about upside down houses. So that is really the point is, honestly, we prefer that the person who got the house is the more responsible spouse, because we do need cooperation with showings and getting financial documents and so forth. So usually, and the one spouse who just wants to be over it, is the one that doesn't fight too much for the house anyway. And it depends. I mean, sometimes it's the woman, sometimes it's the man. It doesn't matter. I mean, just who wants to be done with it, and which one is still trying to fight and save it, or the one who's willing to do what needs to be taken to take care of the situation. So if you've had a situation with divorce, if you've gone through this, if you are you going through this right now, go down to the comments section and leave me a comment. I would love to know what you think about this, or if you have comments about any subject at all in real estate investing, you'd like me to do a video about it, or if you have a question, I would love to respond to you. So go ahead and leave a comment, and that would be awesome. So once we know which spouse is the one responsible for the house who got it in a divorce decree, it's really important to have a smooth short sale, is to get that other spouse out of the way. And the biggest way to do that is to get them to sign a quitclaim deed. Now, You might be thinking to yourself, well, what does it matter if both spouses are on the mortgage? If you sign a quitclaim deed, all they're doing is just deeding all of their property over to, I mean, they're deeding their interest in the house over to the spouse, other spouse. But, you know, the banks have been really good about this. Before it was tooth and nail, and now they've made it easier to do a short sale in a divorce situation. So let's say, for example, if I'm divorcing my wife and I'm saying, look, I'm over it, I don't want to be involved in this, whatever, then what I can do is I sign a quitclaim deed and record it in her, in, so that way she's now the sole 100% owner of the property. If we provide that document to the mortgage company, they're not going to ask me for anything. I'm out of the picture completely. So no pay stubs, no bank statements, no tax returns, no financial statements I got to fill out every 2 or 3 months or however long it takes. So whew, I'm out of it. This is great. Yay. So, and it's easier for us to deal with just one person, and then we don't have to worry about that one. And also that person doesn't have to sign any closing papers either, which is also very convenient. So that's how we try to work this. And unfortunately, divorce attorneys don't talk about this. And so we have to be the ones to educate our clients to let them know how we do this. So the quitclaim deed is probably our biggest weapon to be able to make this a much more smoother sailing process in our, you know, in a divorce situation and a short sale. So if you are in a short sale situation and you're going through divorce or the divorce is already finalized, please go down to the description of this video. There is a website link there for Don Buys Houses. You can go there, click on it, and there's, you know, you can check me out, but there's plenty of spaces there to fill out your information and send a form, your name, your email address, and your phone number. It's all you need to do. I'll get that information. I can reach out to you and we can talk about how we can help you get out of this situation and you know, save your credit and get you some money in your pocket, usually if you're still in the property. So go ahead and do that. Now, if you are a real estate investor and you come upon a homeowner who wants to sell but are in this situation, it's upside down, reach out to us. We can do a joint venture on it. We can do the heavy lifting because that's what our specialty is. And you can, get some of the proceeds that we do as we do God's work in helping homeowners save their credit and get out from under these upside down situations. If you're a real estate agent and someone has come to you in this situation and wants you to list a property, but you really don't want to do it because you don't really like short sales, no problem. Come to us. We'll do everything for you and you can get 25% commission once it closes. And we generally get these things closed because we've been doing it for 20 years. We'd be bankrupt by now if we couldn't make it work. So I want to thank you for coming to this video and watching it. And I hope to see you in the next video. And we can talk more about all this experience I have with short sales. Thanks.